it's proving that that...
Lockdown and the pandemic mean it's been more than a year since these women have been able to share a meal. They're members of the Sister Cancer Support Group, designed to support multicultural Muslim women through treatment. Fit Chu created the group after beating breast cancer and feeling that culturally diverse patients may need more support.
So I thought it would be really great to help them by translating this information for them so that to the level that they can understand.
Now her deep community knowledge is being used to co-design better programs and policies for multicultural cancer patients. Associate Professor Rima Harrison is building a network of diverse health consumers like this to work alongside clinicians.
To be able to have dialogue with each other about healthcare, to kind of make decisions together about what's happening, to identify problems that are recurring.
And hopefully implementation of this intervention will make big difference in the colon cancer patient treatment safety.
Health-related harm is an unintended injury as a result of a patient's medical care or lack thereof. And while there's no single reason colon patients face a higher rate of harm, language as well as cultural barriers and prejudice often lead to errors.
They might be given medication that is for a different patient, you know, often the similar sounding names or names that are in different orders.
A spokesperson for the Federal Health Department acknowledged the discrepancy in health outcomes and says cold is a priority population in several strategies and national action plans. Dr. Harrison says there's a gap when it comes to co-designing programs.
We didn't actually find any frameworks that talk about how to engage people who are from different health backgrounds.
She's now expanding her focus to include patients requiring end-of-life care. Penny Timms, ABC News.